Hello students, friends, followers and my dear colleagues. This question came to me 2 days ago and I thought I should answer this immediately. One student messaged me all the way from Nepal and he says, what if I am not successful in this? What if I am not successful in what I am doing? He's a businessman basically. His father is a businessman. He wanted to take up business, but he says, what if I am not successful like my father? Because his clientele is all based on his father. So he says, what if I am not successful like my father? Very, very, very important question. I want everyone to focus and listen to this. Success is not tough. Success is not toughest either. Success is most cruelest. I'll repeat that. Success is the most cruelest thing you can ever see. It needs everything of you and more than that. And it will not give you any mercy. It will not show you any mercy. If you are working day and night for it, even then you may not get success at all. So people think there's a smart way to become successful. There's a hard way to become successful. There is some formulas for success and all. Let me tell you. There are certain things which you should keep in mind if you want to really become successful. It is not the success which you should aim for. It is the personality to become successful you should aim for. It is not success you should aim for. It is the personality change that is needed to become successful you should aim for. Suppose you want to become a good cricketer. Suppose you want to hit six, right? It is not that you are practicing only six. It is overall performance, overall personality change you have to get in yourself to hit that six. Or for example, suppose you want to become a politician. It is not that you go and beg for votes. It is the entire personality change you get in yourself to become a good politician. If at all you are going to become a businessman, it is not how you learn the business. It is the personality change that you have to bring in yourself to become a good good businessman, right? So there are certain things I want you to keep in mind and try this. Stop giving excuses. This is the first rule for today. Suppose you really want to become successful. Suppose you really want to do something in life. And suppose you are really trying hard for it. Stop giving excuses mentally, physically, to people, to yourself. Stop giving excuses. If these things get into your brain, and if this thing, this one sentence, if it gets into your brain and you are able to process it and you are able to follow it, I'm sure you'll be super successful in anything you do. Stop giving excuses. You want to do something, you have to do it. There is no shortcut, there is no long cut. It is the only way. You want to do something, you have to do it. Stop giving excuses, right? The second thing is, stop showing self-pity. Stop showing self-pity on yourself. Stop that immediately. And don't say, just because my father is like that, I am like this. My mother is like this, I am like this. My financial situation is like this, I am like this. Stop showing self-pity. Don't show pity on yourself. You have to really work hard. This is a super duper machine and you have to really work hard to achieve whatever you want to achieve. And you really have to strive for it, thrive for it, right? And then stop expecting or stop asking for some good luck. There is no luck. There is no good luck. There is no bad luck. There is nothing called luck. Okay, and stop expecting luck. Luck may come to you. You may feel you are lucky, but you should stop expecting luck, right? And you should also stop expecting bad luck. Suppose you are trying to start something and you think, oh, my luck is so bad. Even though I start anything, it will fail. No, don't do that to yourself. Stop expecting luck. Stop expecting good luck or bad luck. Stop. There's nothing called luck. And life gives you so many lucky things and so many unlucky things. You will keep getting them again and again and again. So stop immediately. Immediately stop that. Get that through your mind. There is nothing called luck. You have to work hard for it. You have to work hard for it. You have to do it. You have to do it. You have to be happy in it. You have to be happy in it. That's it. There are certain rules and you have to do it. That's it. That's it. There's nothing big in this. You have to stop expecting luck in your life, right? And stop being mediocre. Stop. Don't be mediocre. Don't be, do little and expect more. Stop doing that to yourself. Never be a mediocre. Give your full self to whatever you are doing. Suppose you are doing some education, give yourself full potential to it. And suppose you are being a businessman, I want you to put your heart, soul, mind, everything into it, right? And suppose you are a spiritualist, put everything to it, right? So stop being a mediocre. Don't do half things. Nothing will happen if you are doing half things. Don't do anything half, or right? So be prepared for this. Don't do anything half, okay? And then success is like, it will come and go. Success will come and go. There are certain unlucky days you will face. There are certain lucky days you will get. There are certain good things it will come up to you. There are certain bad things that will come to you. There will be some days which are successful. There are some things which are not successful. Stop worrying about it. This may look cinematic. This may look dramatic. This may look, oh, this is all motivational speech and all. No, this is reality. This is the only reality. There is no one in this universe who is always successful. There is no one in this universe who keeps expecting success and gets success. No, if you keep expecting success and don't do anything, you will never be successful, my dear boy, my dear girls. So stop expecting things. So to all those who feel, what if I start something? What if I am not successful in this? What is my future? Oh my God, stop doing that to yourself and don't think about if you are not successful, or don't even think about if you are successful. Do what you feel like doing it, and do it with your best ability and do it with your full potential. Is it your NEET examination? Is it your business? Is it your YouTube channel? Is it? Just do it the way you like it. That's the best thing you can do. Give yourself. And you know what? Every day put half an hour for your crying and for your cribbing. Okay? After that, stop cribbing. Suppose you are really in deep financial troubles, really in deep health troubles, really in deep worries. Put half an hour to that and cry. After that, stop worrying about it. Forget about it. If you cry, if there's any problem that gets solved by crying, I will be the first person to cry entire day. There are so many problems, right? So stop crying about things. Right. Here is a very good tip I wanted to give you all. The way I follow, I wanted to give you all. Okay. This is the point. Okay. Which will be projecting your future. Okay. People think like that. And there are so many scriptures which support that. This is the point which will project your future. It will have stored memory and it will come and project your future, right? And suppose if you are projecting your future in a bad way, you will end up in a bad way. May not be as bad as you think, but definitely bad to you and your future. So stop projecting bad things to yourself. Don't do that to yourself. At least in your imagination, at least in your expectation, expect good things. If it doesn't happen, say, oh, that's okay. And if it happens, say, yes, it happened. And you see, the world will work on your expectations. If you believe me, when we get separated from the Paramatma or the God, if you believe me, there's a God, we get separated from the God, and we are like a ball of energy which wants to go back to God, which wants to come back to God. But the problem is, this particle has expectations. This particle has imaginations. This particle has worries about the past and the future. This particle is trained to get distracted, to get worried. Stop doing that. You are a particle of God or or supreme power. If you don't believe in God, there's energy in your body. Every cell has energy. And if you are projecting that energy towards negative things, I'm sure you will end up in negatives. And if you start projecting that to positive, just imagination, it's free, right? Start imagining good things to yourself. It may take time. This is the toughest and the best path, right? Toughest. It will really take long time. But I'm telling you, this is your magic wand. You have to keep imagining good things. Initially, you will feel, I'm imagining good things, but nothing is happening to me. But I'm telling you, it will turn your world around. If you keep striving towards it, keep working on it, right? From today at least, expect good things. Start with a small good thing, smallest good thing. Today, good coffee. You expect good coffee today. At least expect a good biryani today. Expect good things for today. From today, start accepting it. Start expecting good things. And you have to expect everything, everything. No matter you get so many bad things, start expecting good. Start expecting, at least in your imaginations, you should expect good, good, good. And you see the magic? It will come back to you. It will really come back to you. It may take some time. You may fail this NEET examination. You may fail for the first year. But I'm telling you, things will change at least for this time. At least if you see this video, this one single time. Project positive things. Project good things that you want in your life. You think something is good? Expect that. Expect that big. And expect that to happen. It will happen, I'm telling you. It can be your girlfriend, it can be money, it can be your business, it can be your father's health, mother's health, your health, it can be anything. Start expecting. You know, the greatest thing you can do is unwavering, unshakable, undisturbed, expecting positive. If you start expecting that, you may get so many setbacks, you may get so many negative things. But start expecting good things. I'm sure the entire world will work for you and good things will happen to you. So those who ever asked me this question, my dear boy, start expecting good. Take up your father's business. Do it really well. I'm sure you will be successful. And if you're not successful, don't give up. Try some more days. Try a few more days. Try for some more time. And I'm sure you will be successful, right? Hope this video will give you some insight and this will help you for at least for 1 minute. I'll be very, very happy, right? In case you have doubts, please put it in the comment section or please mail it to me, drhrshharish@gmail.com. And if you didn't like that, my advice, ignore boss, just ignore, right? I'll see you in the next video. If you did not subscribe yet, please do subscribe and share it with your friends and like it, right? Chalo, I'll see you. Take care. Bye-bye. Enjoy.